When I sat down to talk to Trappy, it was actually a few weeks ago. I've been sitting on this one for just a little bit. One of the questions that I had for Trappy, which, you know, he's a guy that's been around for a really long time. He's seen the cycles come and go in the industry several times. And I wanted to know from him if he thought the FPV industry was healthy. And, well, you can watch for yourself. You know, based on this conversation, I think I know where this question is going to go. What's your take on the health of the FPV industry in general right now?
That's a tough one. I think that we are recruiting new members at the speed of that we're losing old members. Mm-hmm. And I think a lot of it has to do with the incremental improvements and the useless discussions that I mentioned earlier about how. Yeah, like about, you know, colors of motors and shapes of frames and all of these things that aren't really pushing us further. So I think we're at a stable state. Mm-hmm. In terms of market size. Maybe recently we've been growing a little bit. You know, we've lost quite a few people in the last 2 years. So mm-hmm. I don't know where it's going to go in terms of size. There's still a massive oversupply in terms of companies, and I think that is based on the initial hype that drone racing created. Like, everybody wanted, you know, it was like the gold rush.
Mm-hmm.
And people only saw the good sides of it and never really the bad sides. I don't think the FPV industry is too healthy at this point. Just as like seeing our current and next generation and previous competitors, I don't think there's going to be any room for really radical improvement from within the industry, and that is kind of what is my main concern.
So are you expecting consolidation or disruption or just a general fizzling?
I don't know if I want to talk about that.
Okay, that's fine. That's fine. Yeah. So speaking of the devil that we're talking about here, if I look on that backdrop behind you, you've got Tiny Whoop, you've got Ethics, you've got obviously the Black Sheep, and you've got Rotorex.
Yeah.
I don't see a lot of overlap between those four companies.
Yeah, there isn't, and that's by design. I think, and by the way, apart from Ethics, we don't own any stake in any of these companies. I just think that.
Sure, okay. Yeah.
I just think that they're doing really good things or have been doing really great things in the point of Rotorex. I guess they're in military now and no longer really focusing on FPV,
yeah.
But they are kind of like, the reason why you have so many mini brushless quads right now, that's because of Rotorex.
Okay.
Right? There's no question about it. Like, they started doing miniature quads when everybody was on 400 size platforms.
Right.
And then as we went to mini quads, they were like, that's way too big. You got to be sub 250,
yeah.
2-inch, 3-inch. Same with Tiny Whoop. Tiny Whoop is kind of the spokesperson of FPV right now, because they are bringing in massive amounts of new people, and they're doing it in a family-friendly and accessible way. They are completely distanced away from any of the negative things that I see happening in the FPV industry, and they're mm-hmm. just... if you look at what Jesse has done, mm-hmm. From a point of view of like a complete outsider, he has taken what is a $30 or $40 Walmart toy, mm-hmm. And he's built this glittery world of LEDs and you know, friendships and beer sessions and bar races around what is basically like the cheapest way of making a multi-rotor. Mm-hmm. And that to me just completely, like, I'm in awe mm-hmm. of what this guy has created from like such a simple concept to all of these like really creative ways of exploring FPV in your own home, right? Mm-hmm. So that's like there are so many applications in STEM research and in outreach, like community outreach, that you can, like, it's $150 or $100, or you can buy the clones for $50, right? And right. then you can get to FPV and you can familiarize yourself with the technology. You can even have acro mode, and that's kind of how you get into this entire lifestyle of FPV. Mm-hmm. So that's TinyWhoop. Ethics is, well, it kind of built off the falling out between one of the rotor riot pilots, Mr. Right. Steele,
yep.
Who left rotor riot because he didn't agree with the direction that the company was going anymore, I think. So ethics kind of built around the refinement of the FPV experience, which is, which means like finding little everyday things that make your life inconvenient as an FPV pilot. Mm-hmm. If you look at all of his products, like he's made straps that hold down your GoPro better than any other strap. Mm-hmm. It looks like really simple things, but once you get into the engineering aspect of it, they become really, really challenging tasks. And we worked for months on these straps, and then finally we ended up just buying one that was already on the market, but repurposing it.
Mm-hmm.
And well, I don't want to talk too much about the future products that are coming out, but
sure.
One product that's going to be coming out, it's so trivial, and it took us like a year and a half to get right.
Mm-hmm.
And if you look at this product, and if I tell you like, yeah, TBS, like with all their engineering prowess, took 1.5 years to get this right, you're going to laugh at it. Right. But there's so many little things that were changed along the way, and like, oh no, I want this that way. And the zipper has to open up that way. And just like little things like that, that drove me personally absolutely nuts.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Because I wasn't the guy with the vision behind it. But now I know how my engineers feel, because I'm exactly the same way with all of my things. Right. And they're right. Like, really? Like, does it really matter? And it's like, uh-huh. Yes, it matters. Fuck yes, it matters. And that's the cool thing about ethics. It's like they're really, Mr. Steele really focuses on and obsesses about little details mm-hmm. that make massive amounts of difference. Like, I don't think there's a freestyle motor that is not based off of his motor today. And all it, yeah, there you go. That's the OG. and all of this is based around somebody just saying, like, the current status is not good enough. We have to do mm-hmm. it better. And that's kind of what I was getting at with my whole interview, is like, these are the kind of people that push FPV forward. And if you notice, there, Mr. Steele has a really, like, I wouldn't say a divisive personality, but if you ask 10 people what do you think about Mr. Steele, you're gonna get
10 answers. You're right.
No, and if you categorize him, yeah, you're going to get 10 answers. But if you categorize him, one will say, like, he's the coolest guy ever. And the other people yeah. would say, nah, I don't like him at all. But he doesn't engage in any of this. Like, he doesn't really care about it. He's kind of like, he's a little bit like me. And like, I don't, like, why should I care? Why should I waste my time with what people think about me? I'm doing my thing. And if you want to buy this motor, you buy this motor. And I guarantee you it'll be awesome. And if you don't, fine, you know, it's just mm-hmm. leave me alone. so that's ethics.
So what is I think we got about 4 or 5 minutes left. What is next for, I mean, I know you don't want to talk about products, but you know, you guys own the long range game. There's nobody, I mean, I've seen some of the Free Sky stuff, and apparently it just doesn't compare. I have not had the chance to fly Crossfire yet. I'm hoping I will at some point, but
you're missing out.
you know what? I honestly, I've heard once you fly it, like the latency is noticeable, that noticeably goes down. Yeah. What, where, you know, in the next 3 years, where does Team Black Sheep go?
3 years is a little long to plan ahead.
Mm-hmm.
How far,
let me ask you this. How far out are you planned?
6 months.
Okay.
We have projects that have been going on and will go on for more than 6 months, mm-hmm. but we keep those very, very agile in terms of shifting into any direction that we would like them to. But we are dead set on the next 6 months, so we can't move on the next 6 months, pretty much.
Okay.
I think some of the really cool stuff that I've always wanted to see, like from the beginning that I started FPV, like, you know, that moment when I watched a Roman video, one of those things is going to launch probably within the next 1 to 2 months. And I think that will probably open up the eyes for a lot of people.
Okay.
What my vision of FPV is, and again, if they want to partake in it, then that's good. If not, you know, mm-hmm. all right. We spend a lot of money on it. We spend a lot of time on it. I think it's been probably like 4 years in the making now.
Mm-hmm.
It's built into every Crossfire. It's built into a lot of the products that we've made over the last 2 to 3 years. So mm-hmm. these are, I don't think you have to look for the next 3 years. I think within the next 6 months, things are going to get okay. really exciting.
Thank you. Thank you for your time. I really appreciate
it. Thanks a lot for doing this call.
Yeah, this has been great. And I got to say, I didn't quite know what to expect when we started. And this turned into a great conversation. Thank you.
Thank you.
So where, you know, if you want to push people in a direction, where do you want to push them?
Well, we communicate very openly. Like, my engineers are on the TBS Lounge or the Black Sheep Lounge on Facebook. So if you want to interact with us, if you want to, you know, hang out, that's the place where you can find us. If you want to see some really cool FPV stuff, check us out on Instagram, Black Sheep FPV.
I will say, some of the Instagram stuff you guys are putting up is just blowing my mind.
Yeah.
I mean, it's really sick, and it's not, it's like, oh man, I'm such a failure. That is so cool. I will never be that cool.
It's hard, you know, it's like one of these moments that we managed to capture. I mean, we have a lot of sponsor pilots and also a lot of contributors from the Black Sheep Lounge that post stuff.
Right. Yeah.
And oftentimes I'll just see something and I was like, oh, we got to put that up. And then we asked the guy, like, would you mind if we, like, could you send us the raw clips? We'll polish them up. We'll add, you know, we'll make them snazzy and we'll put them up on Instagram. And that's kind of been our outreach. I think it's, in terms of views, I think the numbers would surprise a lot of people. In terms of, like, how many engagements we get on Instagram and how many people we pull into the hobby that way. So it's been really interesting. I'm not a social media guy. I'm more of, I guess Facebook is social media, but it's more like a forum to me.
Sure. Yeah.
But like, I'm from the old forum days.
Yeah.
That group has been really cool because I get to help people, you know, like on a per topic basis, and we get to discuss certain aspects of it. But Instagram is really interesting.
So very cool. Well, thank you, Trappy.
All right, thank you very much.
I greatly appreciate it. Thank you, buddy. And I'll talk. Hopefully we'll talk soon.
All right.
So there you have it. Trappy doesn't think that the industry is very healthy, and he thinks that we've reached a steady state in terms of the number of pilots that are entering and exiting. And based on some other conversations, I don't know that he is wrong. It was very interesting to talk to him on this one because he has hard numbers to back up those claims, and probably he can just look at his sales data and realize that sales have, you know, when you reach a steady state, that's a plateau. Sales have probably plateaued in certain areas that were staples for them. I am looking forward to whatever that new product is. So Trappy, when it comes out, let me know. Talk to y'all soon. By the way, the next one is going to be what some of you have been waiting for. It is the history of FPV, according to Trappy.